Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? This is our final episode on Melbury Estate, and I've just tipped out some more corn. I've done a couple loads of the wheat. I won't be doing very much more combining because there's something else we want to do, but the field is partly done. I have 278 eggs in my backpack, so I wanted to just come down here and sell these. £3,000 for just under 300 eggs. That's not bad. That's not too shabby at all, really. Right, I need to take this one back because I want the trailer for doing the silage that we're going to start doing in a bit. And I think I've already got a front weight, so I don't need to worry about that. So I will meet you back at the yard. Right, while I just drive along this last little bit here, I'm going to come up through here. I know we did mean to actually sow maize in that field right there, the one that we cultivated. So that is an early priority task on our next map. And that brings me to the question of the week, which is the final question on this map, is which map do you want me to do next? Do you want me to do Sandy Bay Redux version 3? Do you want me to do Thornton Farm? Or do you want me to do Higher Hills version 2.3? I'm going to include a link to each of those videos, each of the maps, in the description down below. You can take a look at the videos, descriptions, really make an informed decision. Sandy Bay will just be played normally. Thornton Farm, if you want me to do that one, I will use soil mod on that one, although I have previously explained my reasons for not particularly wanting to do soil mod, but if you really want it, then I will. It is your vote, it is your game, so you guys get to pick. And finally, I would say that my own personal preference is for Sandy Bay. I would prefer to do Sandy Bay, but I'm happy to do any of them. They're all good mods, they're all good maps rather. They are just sensationally well built and well done. So let me just move this one in here and switch this one off. Like I say, I'm not going to worry about more combining for now. These here, we have a forager. I've got the Rostselmash forager with the Piqup on the front to go with it, and that one I've hired for today, so we'll be using this one because I've not seen this one being used very much. It is not anywhere near as powerful as the crone one that comes as standard, and this is the Peecon that you guys want to use. Whichever map you use, I will start the map with this one, and I've also decided that I will start the map with 50 cows. We won't have any food ready for them, but because if we're going to have this thing, then we need to start the map with something else as well. So I will have 50 cows on there as well, sort of give us a bump start for our 30 episode run before Farming Simulator 17 comes out. So let me just leap into this tractor a minute. We'll start her up and let's back up and hitch on this huge great big machine. Look at that, it's got four rotors inside it. This is a beast of a machine, it really is. It is absolutely huge. Now then, I put that one on. Does it have? Yes, it does have PTO as well, so we put PTO on. There we go. So that one is all hitched up there. Can I climb up this ladder? Don't know if it's going to let me. So I can sort of climb the ladder so I can have a look inside. That's brilliant. Right, let's have a look in here and get the help up. So we got the normal mixing ratios. Stairs up and down. Keypad 9. Oh yeah, that folds the stepladder up there, so that one will lift that one up and down. Backloader console, that's for the tractor, the backloader console, and Rajwit. I don't know what that is. That's also on number 9, so is there anything else happening? There doesn't seem to be anything else happening with it, so that's okay. We'll leave the ladder down for now. Right, I'm going to take this one out to the field where we've got bales of silage, bales of hay. I did actually bale up the rest of that field of hay because I know that I only did like a few runs and I said I would just leave it. It was far too untidy. You know, if we're going to sell the farm, we want to sell it reasonably tidy. So I did a full round around the outside in the straw, and then let me just turn the beacons on. After I did a full round out there, I went on and what did I do then? I finished baling up all of the hay so that we've got, you know, the field's tidy. It's at least completed. And then I brought the baler back. You've seen it back there in the yard. And I know, there is a mower here in this field, which I unhitched here after mowing this field the very first time. And I've been meaning ever since to go back and get it. And I still haven't done it. And I do apologize for that. I know that several people have pointed it out. And I do remember that it is there, it's just I've never actually gotten round to picking it up and moving it. So let's just whiz over here. I'm going to drop in a couple bales of silage and a couple bales of hay, and then we can mix it up. It's just purely so that we can see this thing in action, because I thought that would be pretty cool. And then for the rest of the episode, we will test out the Rostselmash very quickly. And I will do that in more detail on the next map. We will do a bit more silage with the... probably actually use the Rostselmash. It does seem to be a pretty good looking forager, and if you're going to buy one yourself on a farm, you would definitely go for a smaller one rather than a bigger one. Now, I seen the other day someone using a modded fork, and it doesn't have the middle fork, which just seems a much better option, to be honest. It just seems like that would be a much better way to do things. So I might see if I can find that particular fork. Yeah, try and find the right button on my joystick for the boom extension. There we go. Now, I'm hoping that you can just drop these in. I don't think you... There we go. Right, so I have dumped that in. Now, let me just leap out very quickly and see if that has actually put anything. Yes, it's got 4,000. It should be silage. Yes. Right, he's busy doing his dancing, and several people have said, yes, it is a mod conflict, and we're 90% certain that it is the soil and dirt control mod that I run. Which basically makes the fields quite rough and bouncy. Some reason it sort of conflicts slightly with the Fendt tractor. It doesn't really like it, but there's not a lot we can do about that, so it's just something we'll have to live with. It might be that in our next map we don't... Oop, runs. Just pretend you didn't see that. Yeah, in our next map we might just pretend that we don't actually have... next map we might just not use the Fendt tractor. We'll use different tractors, because I mean, we've used the Fendt in this map. We haven't used it a great deal, but we have used it, so I'd like to use something different. And something I am going to do actually in the next map is I'm going to use some of the mid-range tractors, just the vanilla game ones, because surprisingly not many people actually use those. You start off with the small stuff and then you want to upgrade to the big stuff, and you skip out all of the like the mid-range machines. And there is quite a lot of mid-range tractors just from base vanilla game. Can I pick up two? Really, really roughly. That's terrible. So, yeah, you do have the vanilla tractors that are kind of, what's it, about 120 to 180 horsepower. I know that we don't use a huge amount of machinery that requires that. You generally need to go bigger than that. But I thought it would be nice to use some different ones that aren't very often used, like the Ursus is hardly ever touched, and there's a few others as well that very, very rarely get used at all. So we got 12,000 litres of silage in there. I got two bales of hay now, so we'll chuck these in. I got one bale of hay, so let's chuck this one bale of hay in, and then we'll come back and get another one. Let's chuck you in. There we go. Perfect. And down we come. Now, when I was playing Farming Simulator 2013, is that bale going to stay on there? It might. I had two setups that I used. I had one was a modded self-propelled machine that would actually pick up bales itself, and that was absolutely brilliant. And then I had another setup where I built great big stacks, and I used... conveyors, and I had some conveyors set up so that they would you could put the bales on them, and all you need to do is just bring a stack of bales and plonk it in front of the conveyor, and then it would run the bales up the conveyor and drop them straight into the top of the feeder. So I used either one. It depended what I fancied on the day as to which one I would go for. Now, we've had bales sort of roll around, but I only actually baled the outside round. I started moving up and down, and I've just gone around that telegraph pole in the middle, the pylon in the middle. And he's now completely full, so I wasn't going to worry about emptying him, because obviously we're going to be getting on with silage. So let me just grab this bale. Right, you've seen me drop a few bales in, so I will drop two bales here in, and then we'll transport that load back to the yard so that we can just tip it out for the cows, and we can see the very final bit so that we can say that we have actually used the Peecon 64. It is an awfully tight squeeze, but I have managed to get in round the corner. We have 28,000 litres in here at the moment, and if I just bring that one up, you can see it's just within the range for the hay, because think I only put two bales of hay in. Yeah, I put two hay, two straw, and three silage. So it's only just within range for the bales of hay. Let me just open up this gate. We will take this into... Obviously, we can't fit into the alleyway there. Well, I suppose we could from the other end. If we were to come up from the other end, we might be able to fit. But I'd prefer to take it up here, and then we'll see if we can tip it straight in. It should be okay to just tip straight into the trough here. And then for the rest of this episode, they'll at least have the mixed ration, and we'll be able to see if it's effective. Right, there we go. It's got the tip animation. And it's got all four of them go. Excellent. It's got both the gates open up, so you do have to make sure that they're both into the trough. There we go. There's all of that. And there is the Peecon 64 mixer, and I will be using that in the next map. This is something that we will start off with. I know that it's a bit of an unusual machine to start off with, but hopefully our smaller tractors will be able to pull it. There we go. Just move up through here. Right, I will just go and get a trailer, and we'll get ready to do the silage just to finish up with. Here is our Rostselmash. I realise that I am sort of running out of time, so I'm going to speed this along a bit. I did want to take the trailer load of wool that we've got, and we do have a load of wool inside of this cab. Let's have a quick look. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's nice. We'll have a better look at this one in the next map, I think, is what we'll do. But yeah, I've got a trailer load of wool down the bottom, all sort of ready to go. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to come up here and I'm going to start in this field as we've got the trailer and the machine here ready to go. Just bring that here. We've had one growth stage of grass come up. If I park that one there, I'll get the tractor. Yeah, we got all this wool. I think I've got like 8 or 9 pallets, and I wanted to take the trailer down there, load them up, and take them up to the shop to sell them. But unfortunately, I don't think we're going to have time, because we also... I did say that I wanted to go for a walk up the castle, so I'd like to just very quickly take a look at the castle, just like finish up. Now, I got to figure out how to use follow me. No. Right, hang on a minute, I'll get back to you. I think I've got it. Yeah, I just had to go and quickly remind myself how to use the actual controls, because it's been quite a while. Oh, I need to unfold. Hang on. Ah, so we've got to unfold the header, and then come back to the machine. Come back to the machine. Pipe's got to come out. Is there anything else on this one? I've got follow me behind... Wait, resume, follow... Ah, I see. So it does give me some options to use on there. So let me just start this bad boy up. And let's see if I've got this one in the right place. Because I put it to the right. Where's he going to go? He's going to... Right. That's not even close. I want him to go ahead. I don't want him to be behind. Let's see. Head distance, behind distance. Let's try that. See what that does. He's a little bit closer. Obviously, I'm not putting anything into the track here. It might be that he's... Because of where he's going... I've never, ever done this before, and I realise that some of you are probably crying right now because I'm doing this so badly. So let's give that 4 like that, and then behind distance 10, and we'll see what that does. So it's a job to know what the units are for the distance. Okay, now he's just getting too enthusiastic. But if I start driving, he's doing it. Excellent. Now, how well is he going to follow me around this bit? Oh, that is superb. Look at that. I can actually go... Oh, this is brilliant. Okay, it's official. This is one of the best mods that I've ever used. This is sensational. Look at that. Hang on. Let me see if I can zoom out a little bit and get a screenshot. I want to see if I can have this. You'll know if I've got the screenshot properly, because this will be the thumbnail for today's episode. It'd be better if I could get it the other way, wouldn't it? Yeah, let's... there we go. I think I can just temporarily remove that. Oh, that is awesome. I love it. missing a little bit there. Right, I think that that is a good screenshot. That is excellent. Okay, we'll come on up here. It's just we're just going to keep going round until we fill this trailer. We've got one more bit there. And he does seem to be following us really well. He's allowing me to go where I need to go. And I'm getting the right distances on it as well. Oops. Pressed the wrong button there. This is awesome. So I got that offset by 4. And I guess it doesn't matter which side you offset it. You can offset it whichever side you like. Now, obviously, it's not going to do very well if I want to turn this direction, because he's going to get in my way. So I do need to make sure that I do it so that I'm always turning to the left as he's out on the right hand side. But if I'm always turning to the left, he does seem to follow me fairly well. Zooming around a little bit, he might get hung up down here on this machine. I'm hoping he won't. Oh, he's just going to miss it. And there is our issue. Right, so it really doesn't like turning to the right. So if I can go straight up here and just sort of persuade him to go round. So that is a little bit of a problem, is that we can't get him to turn to the right. But generally, he's doing really well. So, and I had a head distance. No, it was behind distance, because it's talking about the machine that it's supposed to be following. And the behind distance was set to 10 rather than set to 5. And oh, he stopped because the trailer's full. I go around throwing it on the floor for ages. Yes, I know. I really should pay more attention to what I'm doing. Right. Control F takes the follow me off. So now if I run through here, we will go and tip this load out. So we've seen that in action. I'd like to go and have a look at the castle. I did want to sell those wool pallets because we got a whole load of them. I thought it'd be pretty cool just to sell one load of them. I apologise that I haven't actually done all the rest that I was going to do, but like I said before, like I explained, really I would like to be able to get another series in on a different map before FS17 comes out, and that is about 10 weeks, so we got 30 episodes that we can do. And I just thought it might be better to do a full series on another map rather than doing another few weeks on here, doing the same old, that we've already seen. So I will try to do tasks that I didn't get to really in this map. So we'll do a bit more with the BGA. I'd like to sort of fill up a bit more of the BGA. So whichever map you send me to, please pick Sandy Bay. I'm not trying to influence you. I wouldn't dream of trying to influence you. But I'm trying to influence you. Yeah. Right, let's just park this one up right here. He can stop right there. That's just fine. We are finished with the fence for now. I'm going to have the Lamborghini over here, and I'm going to hitch that one onto this trailer, and we're going to go and get that wool, because I would like to sell that before I go. Okay. Pulled in here. Let me just turn off that beacon. And I'm going to try and get in. Oop. I want to go a little bit further forward, don't I? I got a whole load of pallets at the back here. So let me just zip back in. Can I get round? Yes. There we go. See what I mean? Hundreds of them. Absolutely hundreds of them. So, go to this bit here. So, I want a toggle load type is J. We got straw round. Oh, no. That's product type is the one. It's X. Hay round, grass, silage, mixed. Wool pallets. That's the one we want. So, now we start automatic loading. And I got the whole lot from that shed. Hang on. Let's just zoom out a bit because it starts at the front. We got space for 2 more pallets, I think. 83%. Yeah, I think it takes 12. Can I get round this corner here? Let me back up a little bit. Because I want to see if I can get that pallet there. Is that one full? Yeah, that's 100% as well. If you take automatically off of a wool pallet collection point with a trailer, it actually kills the wool pallet collection temporarily. Once you log out, see it's saying it's still 100% because I've taken it off automatically. You've actually got to lift it off. If I log out and log back in again, that will work again. But it doesn't really matter at the moment because this is it. This is our very final episode. It's fairly well after this. So let me just turn that off. I'm going to now get up to the store so that I can sell this wool. I've got to get out of here as well, which could take a little while. It takes a bit of shunting sometimes. My last trip up here. It's an emotional day, really. There's our dual wheels that we never actually got to use. We tried them on. And you can, I believe, I know that you can with the Kirovits, we found out in my old times map, you can lift those up with the loader. So I'm assuming you can take those, the front loader, out to the field where the machine is working and do it from there. So let me just see if I can squeeze up between the sign and the wood there. And then to unload this one, I want to try and unload it onto the trailer. So we've got choose unload side, show unloading help. There, unload, oh, toggle side, M. So, trailer. I want to just do it straight to the trailer, and then they should sell from there. So now if I press O. Oh, look at all that money. £200,000. Right. The last thing that I said that I would buy, that I never actually got to just yet, is this one. Hang on. There we go. I'm going to go here. And cars, and I said I would buy a pickup, and I said it would be white to match the Lamborghini, because we were going to have some a bit of color coordination, and then we never actually did it, and then we bought a load of other stuff that wasn't white. But we now have our pickup. Let me just go in cab. Very nice, very nice. Twin cab as well, always important, so you can take the family out while you're going out and checking the sheep. And we're not checking the sheep today, we're having a family outing. So should I do, what's it like on the top? Got alloy wheels. What kind of farm pickup has alloy wheels? That's ridiculous. Right, so we're going to bomb down across here. I can't remember the way to the castle. I know that you, the back of the castle you get, I think we've got to go back down to our field. So what I think I'm going to do is we will go flying along here. I wonder if we're actually going to launch off this bridge. No, we're not going to launch off the bridge. It's not high enough for that. We might launch coming down here. So let me just ease up a little bit. I know I'm going way too fast for this road, but fortunately I've walkie-talkied ahead to the chap in the field. I told him to make sure there was no one up coming up this road so we could go a little bit faster. I'm a forward thinker like that. Hang on, we're going to go cut through the straw field. And I don't know if anyone has ever actually been in a pickup or a car driving through a cornfield. I have. I've done this a number of times. And it's quite something else, the experience, because it sounds that the stubble is normally almost level with the bottom of the pickup or the bottom of the vehicle that you're driving through the field. So you have this scraping all along the bottom of the car, and all it is just the stubble of the, you know, the straw. So it's not doing a huge amount of damage. It certainly cleans and shines up the bottom of the car, I'll tell you that much. But it sounds really, really loud. So you go through quite slowly and you're a bit concerned that it's really, really loud, but it's not doing any serious damage. You do it for too long, you might scrape a layer of paint off the bottom, but that's about it. So yeah, it's actually, I've done that a few times. So how far up can we get? We don't want to be driving in National Heritage site too much. So there we go, we've ridden in our white pickup, and we're just going to take a break, and we're going to come and have a look at the castle. So I do like having, I actually go to visit, the town that I live in has a castle right on top of the hill, right beside where I live. And you can't actually see it from the house I live in now. I used to live in a flat that was like literally underneath the castle. You look out my window and you could see the castle there. But I live right next to, it's like I'm maybe 500 yards away from a castle. And it's right up on top of a hill. You get fantastic views when you go up. I do enjoy going and looking at the castle. Going for a walk up there every now and then. It is nice. So here is our castle here. Come out this side. There is awesome views out there. I have really enjoyed playing this series, and this was my first Farming Simulator Let's Play series, and I can't thank you enough, everybody, for the support that you have shown me since I started this series. It has been sensational. My channel has grown tremendously since I started this, because all of you seem to really, really like what I'm doing with the Farming Simulator Let's Play, and in part, this is down to all of you. Well, mostly this is down to all of you. I ask you the question, I ask you what you want me to do, but you're the ones that are making the decisions. And that is how it's going to continue on my channel. I will ask you guys how you want me to play it, because you're the ones that are watching it. And that's what I'm going to continue doing. So obviously, This is the final series. I need you to tell me which series you want me to go to next, which map. So is it going to be Sandy Bay Redux version 3? Is it going to be Thornton Farm with soil mod? Or is it going to be Higher Hills? And once again, I will say that my personal preference is for Sandy Bay Redux 3. It doesn't have soil mod, or it is soil mod enabled, but I won't be using it on that map because I don't want to. If you really desperately want me to use soil mod, that would be on Thornton Farm. Let me go back up to the top again. I liked it up here. That's about all I got time for, I think. That is it for this series. And I apologize, it was a little bit rushed this week, but obviously I did explain that because we're running out of time, I wanted to try and get a good series in on the next map as well. So we have done some. Obviously, we've got this field here that hasn't been done. There's a few fields down there that haven't been touched. And I'll try and sort of prioritize those tasks in the next map. So until next time, thank you very much for watching, everybody, and thank you so much for the support. If you've enjoyed the episode, please head down below and give me a like, and if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends about me. Get them to watch as well. And again, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.